So one of the new features inside After Effects 2023 is the new Properties panel. So in this video, I'm going to be breaking it down and showing you how you can use it to really speed up your workflow inside After Effects. So let's dive in. So I'm inside Adobe After Effects and I have this project open. To get to the Properties panel, just go up to Window Properties. This will open up to the right side. You can dock it. I recommend docking it to the right. Now you'll notice if you grab the Shape tool, you'll notice that there's a toggle on and off properties button, as well as an auto open panel button. So you can see if you toggle it, it'll hide and unhide. And then if you uncheck auto open, this will stop it from opening if you don't want it to open automatically. So those are the options up top. Now let's dive into how the panel works. If you click on a layer using your selection tool, you'll notice that the basic layer transform properties pop up inside the properties panel. This allows you to make adjustments right in the properties panel without twirling down in the timeline panel. As you can see, you can make keyframes automatically in the properties panel by clicking the stopwatch icon and then going out forward in time and changing the value. For example, I'm changing the scale to 80%. And then knocking down the opacity to about 50. Now, another way that you can use the properties panel is with text layers. When you select the text layer, you'll notice that basically the character panel and paragraph panel pop up inside the properties panel. You can change the font, you can change the casing, the fill, the stroke, and then there is a more button as well where you can change more options. Now below, you'll see the paragraph panel where you can change the alignment. Now at the very bottom, you'll notice that you can actually add an animator. When you click this, you can choose your animator, for example, scale, and this will add an animator directly into your timeline. This saves some time because otherwise you'd have to twirl down into your text and then go to the animate button and then select it from there. Now, probably one of the best features about the properties panel is when you're using it for shape layers. For example, here I'm drawing out a new shape, and you'll notice to the right under layer controls that the shape's listed. Now, one thing with shape layers is that you can add several shapes to one layer. So for example, if I create some new ellipse layers as well as that rectangle, you'll see them also be added to the layer controls to the right side. And when you click on each one, you can edit them individually down below. So for example, I'm making this ellipse a little smaller. And if I click on the rectangle, I can make this a little bit bigger. And you can see how you can easily change the settings for each one using the properties panel. Now you can select all of them and change a value for all shapes that are selected. And you have other options such as changing the fill color, changing the stroke color. And this is a lot easier than, going down into the timeline and trying to twirl down and find each individual setting. It's right here inside the new properties panel. So that's the new properties panel inside After Effects. Let me know your thoughts on it. Leave your comments down below. I'll definitely be using it for shape layers as I think that's probably the best way to use it, but there's a lot of use cases for this new feature. Hope you enjoyed the video and we'll see you next time.